In 1920, he quit his education at the medicine school in his fourth year and focused on his musical training when an Egyptian princess became his benefactress. And in Prague, he graduated the conservatory as a violin virtuoso. Due to his benefactress's financial decline, Mr. Rüsselmann returned home. Since he was fluent in German and French and good at English languages, he could read and study the books and treatises of all leading theoretical spiritualists of that era. Of the trailblazers of the classic spiritualism, among them Alan Kardec, Gustave Jolaire, Charles Richer, Leon Denis, he learned hypnosis from these books before he was back to Anatolia. He began teaching music. Between 1926 to 1935, he worked as a music teacher and then returned to his education in the medicine school, restarting from the second year and graduated. Afterwards, he worked as a physician in many places. He had a practice in İzmir, yet he was such a truthful and just person. That some injustices his colleagues made led him to make some hard decisions for giving up his practice. In the meantime, he continued his spiritual work, and one of the most well-known ones was the seances he held in 1936 with musicologue Saadettin Arel as the medium, where they received spiritual communiques from the disembodied being called Üstad, Master.
Bilgiler alıyor. Bu da Üstad adı verilen bedensiz bir varlık tarafından alınan celseler başlıyor.
As he studied and compiled the knowledge gained through these spiritual communiques, the birth of the neo-spiritualism came emerged.
O çalışmalarla ne yapmış, ortaya çıkmış.
So, he worked in many places and levels. As he worked at Bakırköy Mental Hospital, he published a magazine titled Fener, Lantern, in
1938.
Let me share some slides with you.
O sunumunu göstermek istiyorum yaptığı çalışmalarla birlikte.
Evet. Yes, the publication of the magazine Fener, his musical work, and at the same time, the seances he held, fulfilling his military duty as an army physician with the captain rank in 1940 to 1941, later traveling to Afghanistan in 1943 with other physicians like Sevil Akay, MD, one of the first Turkish spiritualists, writing, etc. As you can see, back then, well-educated people like physicians were more interested with spiritual subjects. In 1946, Mr. Rüsselmann returned to Turkey and started a new school of neo-spiritualism, especially with his book titled Ruh ve Kainat, Spirits and Universe. He elaborated on the knowledge acquired from these spiritual communiques from Master and on the human being, death, hereafter, conscience, evolution, destiny and reincarnation. Again, in 1947, he worked in İzmir as a physician, and later in Ankara cruise boat, where he could find more time in his hands to write his books. He worked intensely between the years 1947 to 1954, by conducting seances for spiritual communiques. In the meantime, he lectured in the universities, published his book titled Ruhlar Arasında, Among the Spirits, in 1950. And here is a slide displaying his books I mentioned.
Şurada Bedri Bey'in size olsaydım bütün kitaplarını da evet görebiliyoruz çıkan eserleri anlattıklarım. İşte
1951, and in 1951 Allah his book titled kitabı, Allah is published. And with the purpose of sharing all this knowledge he acquired in March 30, 1950
adına da
he founded the Metaphysical Research and Scientific Investigation Society with Sevil Akay, MD, lawyer Suat Plevne, Muammer Bayurgil and Nurettin Özmen. In 1952, he published another periodical titled Ruh ve Kainat, Spirit and Universe, and his book titled Mukadderat ve İcabat, Destiny and Necessity. And also, in 1951 in Stockholm, the International Congress of Spiritualism was held, and he submitted a report of 61 pages titled Medyumluğun ve Ruhların Dünyamızdakilerle Görüşme ve Münasebetlerinin Neo-Spiritualizma Görüşü ile İlmi İzahı, The Scientific Explanation of Mediumship and the Communication of Spirits with Our World in the Light of Neo-Spiritualism. The attendees were so impressed with his report that Mr. Hitchcock, the president of the International Spiritualism Federation in London, wrote him a letter in admiration. During his intense spiritual work, Mr. Rusaman conducted seances for more spiritual communiques, from the beings that named themselves as Kadri, Mustafa Molla, Şihab and Kemal Yolcusu. He published the knowledge he gleaned from those beings in his books. Here in this slide, you can see the signatures of the founders of our society and their official applications for the society. Today, I'm giving snippets from history, impressions from of those times.
Hani o anların bir anılarını vererek.
Here you can see the membership card number one of Bedri Rüsselman.
Bu metafizik tetkikleri kurduğundaki
with his signature and thumbnail photo.
Kendi imzası resmi o zamanlardan hakikaten kalan.
These are very important memories for us.